Blackstone presents The Hunting Ground by Jean Heller. This book is read by Christine Lakin. This book is dedicated to a street kid named Charles, who wandered into my life one day and captured my heart. He was in foster care and separated from a little brother he adored, yet he never stopped smiling. I didn't realize it at the time, but Charles planted the seeds for this story. Chapter 1. A midwinter thaw in Chicago had transformed the Dan Ryan Woods nature trails into sucking bogs of wintry sludge. Any misstep could yank off a boot and morph a casual stroll into a frigid mud bath. But the sun was out, the temperature had mounted a frenzied climb into the upper 40s, and the day dictated some quality time outdoors. I had no inkling that a simple woodland walk would hurl me into a personal and professional train wreck. Mark Hurst and I stepped around the worst of the muck, large, soupy brown puddles fringed with sparkling beards of ice. Our progress was slow, but we didn't care. We were out to get some exercise on a nice Saturday in January and let Mark's Irish setter Murphy run off the cobwebs of winter. Watery sunlight filtered through barren trees down to the floor of the sprawling forest preserve deep on Chicago's south side. The trees cast long shadows to the north, elongated silhouettes in haphazard formations falling across the snow crust. The branches looked like the scrawny, outstretched arms of old men, ending in impossibly twisted, arthritic twig fingers. Tree shadows, long and sharply defined, were among the sights I cherished most about winter. Had I chosen to be a painter instead of a writer, this was the sort of scene I would put to canvas. Perhaps I would try it someday. The sun's meager heat barely penetrated our layered clothing, but the dark bark of the trees absorbed the scant warmth and radiated it back into the surrounding air. It created circles of snowmelt that girdled the base of each trunk, as though the ground had sunk away with perfect symmetry. Mark and I held hands and listened for the occasional crashing of Murphy's large body as he careened through underbrush, chasing squirrels he would never catch. The fun was in the hunt. The Dan Ryan Woods were named for an early Chicago Democratic machine politician who died in 1923 after serving as the president of the Cook County Board, and little else. But this inner-city parkland paradise, with ball fields and soccer fields at the north end, and wilderness over the rest of its expanse, was a treasure in a part of the city most people associated with gangs and violence. It was an oasis of peace and quiet, and a wonderful way to hike off stress. An assortment of wintering birds, cardinals, nuthatches, chickadees, downy woodpeckers, even a flock of cedar waxwings, feeding on thawing wild berries, went about the business of survival as if we weren't there. It was too early for the onset of their nest-building instincts. Their only concerns this day were finding sufficient food and shelter, not to mention adult bird beverages. The berries wolfed down by the waxwings had fermented on their trees all winter, and more than a few of the birds displayed highly erratic flying behavior.
"Somebody should have carted them before letting them in here," Mark said.
I grimaced. "I hope they don't get hurt." Mark circled me with his right arm and hugged me to his side. "We fit together perfectly." He said,
"You want to round them up and take them home until they sober up? Make them teeny tiny cups of black coffee and give them a place to sleep it off?"
He looked down at me and grinned.
"Deuce Mora, famous newspaper columnist, notorious lover of fur and feathers."
In my own defense, I replied, "Friends don't let friends fly drunk."
"They'll be fine," Mark assured me. "They've been doing this since the species evolved. I don't see little waxwing bodies all over the ground."
We moved on and saw three coyotes, a species that had spread its range into Chicago in recent years. A red fox paused.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.